the actors. Okay, so what I wanted to talk about, today was about Rudy and without the backyard. Basically, there's no fence down our backyard. There used to be actually be like a fence where he could run around like, boom, and he'd hit like a fence. Obviously, we're not bumping the fence. We had a dog called like dig. He used to like dig underneath the fence. Like he would dig underneath the fence, and he like go the other side, and boom, he'd be back up. But obviously, we put dog collars like and like zap him. But now there's no fence, so he can just go, boom, just dart off of the fence, everything, like dart away. So we obviously have to take a collar, put a collar on like we normally walk him. We got the collar on the table like where he can't get away. But like there's no fence, and we're right by the road, so when people walk by, that their dogs or they're just themselves, he will go bark at other people. He'll start barking at their dogs. And we're like, stop it. So we have a barking collar, but we don't always put it on because it's more convenient just to put them outside. Then you gotta come out with the dog collars. It charges, but it only lasts like a few hours. You have to recharge it. So it's like very confusing to like keep it all. Not really confusing, but it's very, you know, inconvenient. Our other dog, our Papillon, Rowdy, does not bark at the chair. Not very often. If he's out here with him, yeah, they'll both start barking, but yeah. That's the thing. So there's no fence, so he didn't run away. Luckily, but one day when I was walking, though, the leash, like, came unhooked. It was like, what the crap? But you're so fat, though. Like, we're also at, like, where we're at parks. So, yeah, basically, time of the day, that's the only thing we do. But, yeah, when we're at parks, though, he starts laying down. Like, after he starts walking, he starts, like, shaking his head around and, like, saliva. I think because he's panting really hard. So, if he started to lay down, I had to start carrying him because he was getting so tired he couldn't continue walking. I don't think he's getting old. He's about to turn 6 this July. So he's about to turn 6, but and they usually live for about 11 years to 12. Well, for anywhere from our other pom live for 11 and a half. So I know he has obviously like 5 years left. He's not like on his last leg. So I think he's just probably just overheated or something probably. That's why we usually have to carry him or like get into water. Whenever he gets in the water, he'll like lay down in the water and like, what are you doing? Like he once laid down inside of a mud puddle and I was like, oh my gosh, my bone is in a mud puddle. It's a canvas, you. But yeah, he laid down inside of a mud puddle, and he got all dirty. I had to give him a bath later on that day. But that's basically what I wanted to say, is he with dog fences. Basically, there's no fence, so he can escape. We obviously can't put a fence in, no duh. Big Pom is like,
oh my goodness, what's your motion? You're so pretty, aren't you, baby?
Big and fluffy. So yeah. He's so fat right now about this. So yeah, that's all I wanted to say. Basically, because of a lack of fence, we have to time to the table. And he's gotten much fatter than he used to be. That's his horn. That's no one okay? Okay about this? I can't say goodbye to you.